Hello students, today we are going to start the topic sexual reproduction in plants. The sexual reproduction in plants, the main reproductive organ is a flower. Flower is the main main role in a sexual reproduction in plants. So flower is a structural unit of sexual reproduction in plants. It consists of four floral whorls are there: calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. All these parts are shown in diagrammatically in hibiscus flower. So the main four floral whorls are take part in sexual reproduction in plants: calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. Androecium is the part of male part, and gynoecium is the part female part. So both the androecium and gynoecium are take part in sexual reproduction or reproduction in flowers. Then calyx and corolla is accessory whorls, and they are use or main function in the flower is accessory whorl, and these accessory whorls are is important for to prevent to protect the inner whorl, androecium and gynoecium. Then calyx and corolla are called as accessory whorls, and androecium and gynoecium are called as essential whorl. What is mean by accessory? Means to protect the inner whorls, and essential whorls androecium and gynoecium. Androecium and gynoecium are take part in a sexual reproduction in a plants. So it is called as essential whorls. Calyx and corolla are called as accessory whorls because to protect the inner whorls, like as androecium and gynoecium. Calyx and corolla are it is the outer whorls, and androecium and gynoecium is the inner whorls. Then accessory whorls are protect to inner whorls. Then members of calyx are called as sepal. The member of calyx, it is called as sepal, and members of corolla, it is called as petals. The member of corolla, it is called as petals. So sepal is green in color. That part of flower, the color is green in color, and corolla are the various colors in nature. So that time corolla called as petal are colorful, and so it is calyx, it is called as sepal, and sepal is green in color. So it is the main part of the flower. So main part of the flower is the main floral whorls are take part in sexual reproduction in flower. Calyx, corolla are called as outer whorls. They protect the inner whorls. Androecium and gynoecium is the inner whorls. So calyx, it is called as sepal. Corolla, it is called as petals. Sepal is green color. Petals are various color. Then are diagrammatically shown. This is the hibiscus flower. In hibiscus flower, it is like as that tube-like part. It is called as style. Then that top part, it is called as stigma sticky, and the ovary is the basal part, is the ovary. Means stigma, style and ovary, it is the part of gynoecium, and anther and filament, it is the part of androecium. Androecium is male part and gynoecium is female part. Both parts are take part in sexual reproduction in plants. And then outer whorls is the calyx and corolla are there. Then the sexual reproduction in flower, so that time the flower is called as bisexual flower. Flower is the, if the both whorls, that is androecium and gynoecium, are present and on the same flower, so it is called as a bisexual flower. Both the whorls, they are present in same flower. Here the androecium and gynoecium, both the whorls, they are present same flower, so it is called as bisexual flower. Then the, like as example, hibiscus. Many flowers have a stalk for support. It is called as pedicellate flower. So stalk of flower it is called as pedicellate flower, and without stalk of flower it is called as sessile flower. So hibiscus flower is pedicellate. Why pedicellate? Because that flower is a present stalk of flower, it is called as pedicellate, and the without stalk of flower it is called as hibiscus flower. Then androecium is the male whorl, and the member are called as stamens. So that member of androecium it is called as stamen, and the part of gynoecium it is called as the carpels, the female whorls, and it is gynoecium, it is called as carpels. So androecium it is called as floral whorls, it is called as stamen, and gynoecium it is called as floral whorls, female, it is called as the carpels. Then the actual reproduction in flower. So firstly, pollen grains transfer to stigma, means pollen grains are made by an androecium part by anther, and anther is bilobe. This anther is bilobe. It is two-folded. So it is called as two folds are there, one and two. So it is called as anther, it is bilobe, and anther to produce a pollen grains. And that pollen grains and that polar anther and filament, it is the part of androecium. Anther is main function to produce pollen grains and filament to support. So that time anther, the pollen grains will be transferred to the female part. It is the stigma, and stigma is sticky. So stigma is sticky. So that time that number of pollen grains, they are stick to stigma, and that time stigma is the female part. So androecium, they are transferred the pollen grains, and pollen grains is the male germ cell, and that male germ cell are directly goes through as they are stand on sticky part is the stigma, and stigma to it is the essential number of pollen grains are there. So number of pollen grains means number of male gametes are there, male germ cell are there, but essential for reproduction of flower, it is the two male gametes are essential, and two pollen grains, two male germ cell are essential for reproduction of the flower. So that time the number of pollen grains are deposited on the stigma, but essential only two pollen grains, they are directly goes through a tube like part, it is called as style, and the style is directly joined to basal part, is the ovary, and main reproduction process can occur in that ovary. So that time stigma, the two pollen grains are transferred to that pollen tube, and pollen tube, they are transfer the pollen grains to the that part of the ovary, and that time that they are transferred to ovary, that two gametes. So that time that style will be burst, and style will be burst. So that time reproduction process can occur. So firstly, pollen grains are transferred to stigma. Stigma is sticky part, it is the female part, and that female part only transfer the two pollen grains, number of pollen grains, but the essential for pollen grains for reproduction is two male gametes are useful. So that time two male gametes are sent to that part is the style. Style is tube like part, and they are attached to vessel. Vessel part is the ovary, and two pollen grains are transferred in that part. So that time basal part, that pollination, the pollen grains are stick to stigma. It is this process, it is called as pollination. Pollination are occur, two agents are there, abiotic agent and biotic agent. Abiotic agent like as wind, air, water, like as abiotic, and biotic means like as insect. Via through that insect and via through air, water, they are transfer the pollen grains to the stigma. It is called as simple way pollination. Pollination occur two types, abiotic and biotic. Biotic means their pollen grains are transferred via through insect. It is called as biotic, means that biotic agents, and abiotic agent is via through air, water, and the air, water, they are transferred to the stigma. It is called as abiotic agent. Then long pollen tube, they transfer the two pollen grains inside the basal ovary. So that time towards the male gamete are formed, and pollen tube get burst, and pollen tube get burst. So that time the embryo sac towards the male gamete release to embryo sac. This is the embryo sac. It is the part of ovary. And embryo sac, so that time one male gamete are fused with one egg cell and to form a zygote. And then second male gamete, first male gamete is fused with egg cell to form a zygote. And second male gamete are fused with a polar nuclei and to form endosperm is formed. So all these process, the fertilization can occur in two stages. So it is called as that fertilization of in flower, it is double fertilization. First is first gamete, one male gamete are fused with egg cell and to form zygote, and second male gamete are fused with polar nuclei to form endosperm. It is the two way, so it is two times, so it is called as that that type of reproduction can occur in flower. So it is called as double fertilization. Simple way, I will explain that topic. Sexual reproduction in flower. It is simple way in sexual reproduction in plants. It is more important. Four florovores are take part in sexual reproduction in plants. So it is the calyx, corolla. Calyx, corolla are only protective. It is accessory whorls. They are protective flower and main essential whorl. Androecium and gynoecium. Androecium is the male and gynoecium is the female. Androecium and gynoecium. Gynoecium part is two. Anther and filament and gynoecium is the three parts, stigma, style and ovary. So anther is the main function, pollen grains are deposit, pollen grains are to form and produce, and they are transferred to via through pollination process can occur to directly transfer a biotic and biotic agent. They are transferred to stigma. Stigma is the sticky part and this part is the female flower. So two pollen grains are essential for fertilization process. So that time two male gametes, they are directly goes through transfer by style. Style is tube like part and that direct goes to attach. The basal part is the ovary and two male gametes, they are transferred to the embryo sac, that like part ovary, and that time that pollen tube will be burst and that time fertilization process can occur. First male gamete is unite with first egg cell and to form a zygote, and second male gamete are there fused with polar nuclei to form a endosperm, and this fertilization occur in double, so it is called as double fertilization process can occur in plants. So two types of pollination, cell pollination and cross pollination. Cell pollination means that pollination involves only one flower or two flowers born on same plant. It is called as cell pollination. And whereas involves is the plants of some same species. And what is meant by cross pollination? Two species are differ and that male gametes are transferred to that another flower part, another species. So it is called as cross pollination. Cell pollination means same species, and same species they are transfer the pollen grains from one plant to one flower to another flower. So it is same plant. So it is called as cell pollination. And cross means the variety means different species. Their pollination can occur. It is called as the cross pollination. And seed germination means seed germination process can occur inside the soil. So seed will be, they are directly somewhere or directly mixed into the soil. So that time in that seeds, they are there like as the part, the fertilization process can occur by seeds. In the seeds are ground, fruits break, and that time it is the seed germination process can occur by with the help of water and oxygen, air. So that time first radical will be plumate, it will be to form. So that time that favorable condition and zygote develop are in the it is the cost of food store in endosperm, and that endosperm all nutrition sent to that seeds, and thus and the plantlet will be formed. Means that endosperm is the nutritional material are there, and that time that radicals will be grow inside the soil, seed germination process can occur and to produce a new plants, and via through that track. So it is called as the seed germination process. Seed germination, so first in that endosperm, it is genetic material are there, it is the main that material to nutritional value are there, so that time that support to growing the or seed germination process can occur by with the help of that nutritional by endosperm, and seed will be germinate and to form a new plants. Thank you.